Assalamualaikum. Now, a little while ago, I did a panel cut dress, and one viewer or member online has had problems with trying to get the measurements precise, and on several occasions she's actually asked me to make a clear video on how to go about cutting the panel cut dress. Now, it's actually quite difficult to understand, because I thought on that particular video that she was referring to, I had done a full well explanation of what it was, because not only did it show the me cutting and the sewing of the garment, but it actually went on to show the actual garment being worn. So it was a practical demonstration of how I went about cutting the fabric, making the suit, and then wearing it and showing the actual result. And I personally I did think that it was self-explanatory what I was doing, and you would have understood it. Now, you might find, if you're randomly watching the video, you're going to find the video quite complicated, because it's referring to a particular person's problem, and which I hope she finds her solution in this video. So she sent me a sketch. I'm not exactly sure where it is that she's having the problem, but she sent me a sketch which sort of looked like this. It was a cut fitted dress, which was a slight cut on the shoulder, and also a cut where there's generally a dart line. So there's a couple of things to bear in mind when you're making a dress like this. First of all, I mean, like the only misunderstanding that we had, and we've gone over this online several times, where she's been sending me messages, and obviously I'm busy and I can't reply to everybody's personal queries. I try and address as many people's problems as much as possible. But I didn't understand, because what she basically said was that her garment was coming out too tight around the shoulder area. And my point was, well, if it's coming out too tight, then why do you not widen these panels, and that will solve the solution? To be honest, I'm still a little bit confused on exactly what she wants me to say to that, but I'm going to give my opinion on what I feel is going to be like a solving issue. So first of all, when you're doing a cut dress that's going to be cut in the center, you've got to bear in mind that, are you going to cut the dress excess wide and then cut the panels, and then when you reattach them back up, are you going to bring shape into it? Or are you expecting to cut the panels accurately, joining them back up, and then still expecting to have a flare? Am I making sense of this? No, I'm not. I'm not even making sense to myself. Well, anyway, let's just cut this and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So if we're cutting something like this in the original form of what it is, and this is just our sample explanation template. Now, depending on just how much of a margin you left, now if we're stitching that back up, then and we're getting a fitting, we have got a slight bit of excess on the waistline, and we've got a slight bit of excess around here, which if we take those out, we're not exactly getting a massive flare at the bottom. Whereas if we want to create a flare around here, then obviously we've got to cut these pieces separately and put them back together, or we cut them quite wide out of the same piece. Now, the same piece, if we're cutting this again, okay, but what we're doing is we're using that side as our center. And then, instead of cutting it here, we're making this quite wide. Perhaps this wide. So we're leaving all this excess, okay? So we're using that as our measurement for the waistline. We're using that as our measurement for the side. We're using this as our template hooked to the bust point, and then we're bringing it on the waistline. We're meeting, and then this we're going to sort of go like that. So we're using the same fabric, but we're just not cutting into it. Then on the other side, again, we're cutting around for the neckline up to the shoulder point, and here we're leaving that and we're taking that. So we've got all this excess that we're going to take away, and we're going to get the shape. So this is one way of doing it. Okay. And I hope this explains the confusion. Now these aren't on measurements or anything. This is just a rough cut giving you an explanation of the procedure. This is one way of doing it. Now what we've got is, when we reattach these back up, what we've got is we've got flare. That excess that we've taken out from the center has meant that the bottom of the gear of the dress is going to give us the flare. So when this is attached, it's going to give you, it's obviously going to give you the fitting for the bust, and it's also going to give you the flare, because we've used a lot of, we've taken that much fabric out from all the sides, and that's what's given us the flare. Now if for instance you are coming out too tight on the bust, then obviously you would increase slightly on the areas of the bust, or you can increase it on the center. If it's coming out too tight around the shoulder, then it's just natural that you would increase that instead of cutting it. I can't give you precise measurements because everybody's own measurements are their own sizes. So if your shoulder was 16 inches and half of that was 8 inches, you know for sure that you've got to keep this 8 minus the neckline and minus the shoulder cut. And then what you left with on top of the shoulder, you've got to bear that in mind, that you've got to leave your seam allowance and what that particular garment has got to be left as ready. The other thing that you can do, if you're afraid that you're going to make that mistake, is perhaps not do the armhole cutting. Attach the pieces, then measure the shoulder after you've cut the and take the armhole out after you've done that, and that will save you from making that mistake where you've gone and made it too tight on the shoulder. Even the fitting line, you can leave the margin excess and you can mark it out later. So I hope that you know, solves part of the problem. Now there's two or three ways of cutting this. That's just one method. Okay, alternatively, what you have is, that's your side panel and that's your center panel. Now it's obvious, once these cut, they're not the same. They're going to be cut, you know, the same ones were these, but then in the same ones, if you're not taking excess material out, you're not going to get the flare. Do you understand? If you're making a straightforward dress, that's perfectly fine. But if you're creating like a fairly large wide umbrella cut, then there's no way, without actually taking excess material out from the top portion, because what you've got to remember is you're creating a quite a large width gear, and you're not going to have that. I mean, the other alternatives are that you add kalyan to where the insertions are. So there's lots of solutions. It's not a preset design. You're playing around and you're working around with the ideas to create your own. So that's one. Okay, the other ways of doing this would be to cut them individually, so you get less wastage of fabric. So if you are cutting the one piece from the one side, then you are cutting on the alternative side, and if the fabric doesn't have a flow, like one-sided flow, then you can cut one from one side and the other from the other side. And when you're measuring and when you're cutting, just bear in mind that you are actually working in the center of the fabric, and you are going to be losing a slight bit of fabric on both sides. I mean, like if you're looking at the example of you're imagining this to be your fabric, and you're losing this much from one side, you're losing quite a bit from the center. On these kind of designs, you do need plenty of fabric. So that's just one way. That's another way of cutting this. Now, I have got a larger patterns that I have cut in this, and there is an Urdu version of this on my website. You can, there is an Urdu channel which has been set specifically for Urdu viewers, and I have done a fairly large width jacket style in Urdu. So a complete pattern making facilities available there, so you can go on to the Kapasilai, or you can go on to the website and actually go and you know, look for yourself and find this video. I hope this helps and has been beneficial for you, and you go on to experiment and perhaps try out something like this.